Greetings to everyone. I'm Lalith Kishor R, currently pursuing my third year bachelor's in electrical and electronics engineering. We all have our mobile phones, and for it to fully charge, it takes about 1 to 1.5 hours. And for an electric car, it takes about 8 to 10. And the chargers and batteries in both mobile phones and electric cars use copper wiring. And there is a better alternative for copper, which has about 70% higher electrical conductivity than copper and can decrease the charging time. And that material is graphene. Graphene is often called as the wonder material of the 21st century. It is just one atom thick layer of carbon arranged in a honeycomb-like pattern. And this thinness is the main reason for its electrical conductivity. And to put simply, the brilliance of it, it is stronger than diamond, more electrically conductive than copper, and is more flexible than rubber. It has the potential to revolutionize industries in fields like power generation, where it can be used to make efficient solar panels, and in fields like electrical vehicles manufacturing. But the application which interests me the most is the change it can make in the electrical vehicles industry. One of the main reasons why people opt for gasoline power cars rather than electric cars is that charging can take a lot of time. If we use graphene in the chargers and batteries of electric vehicles, the charging time can be decreased by up to 70%, which could possibly increase the number of electric cars in the roads. Electric cars are the need of the hour, as they are an important part in battling climate change. However, no greenhouse emissions come directly from the electric vehicles. The electricity that they use to charge themselves still comes from power plants, which use fossil fuels. But the current emissions can be cut down by up to 43%, which is still a sort of improvement. Graphene can offer us many ways for a sustainable way of living, and one such is the average lifespan of electric car of electronic goods is from 3 to 13 years and are disposed after that. Recycling electronic goods isn't like recycling paper. They are difficult to recycle because of their complex design and the variety of materials used to manufacture it. And sometimes recycling electronic goods can cost more than the worth of the materials. And according to a database company called Statista, the global electronic goods waste reached a record high of up to 53.6 million tons in 2019. And graphene can offer a solution to it. Imagine if graphene can replace the glass, plastic, or even some hardware parts in the smartphones would become highly durable and reducing the waste generated. And carbon capture technology, which is a method to capture the carbon dioxide which is emitted into the atmosphere. And the captured carbon is then stored in deep sea vents or deep underground. It uses a silica membrane which captures and filters the carbon particles. And according to the Global Carbon Capture and Storage Status Report, which was published in 2020, about 40 megatons of carbon is captured annually and is stored, which is just 0.1% of the total carbon emissions. And meanwhile, the EPHL Basic School of Sciences created a carbon filter which is made out of graphene, and it surpassed the efficiency of other carbon filters. As of told by the researchers in the EPHL Basic School of Sciences, it has a separation factor of about 22.5 and can increase the carbon capture by up to 10 times. But the main problem with graphene is that it cannot be mass produced. That is, it cannot be synthesized in large amounts. And the key reason is the cost. And this high cost of graphene has also slowed the global commercialization of graphene. And more recently, in 2021, Indian Institute of Technology, Patna, came up with a cheap way to produce graphene by using plasma gun and gas phase ions. At just $1.12 per gram, and can produce up to 48 grams in an hour. And this quest for a more affordable and more efficient way to produce graphene is not going to stop. And just like the first discovered metal by early humans, which is copper, which helped people civilize, develop, and forever change the fate of the humanity, which we are now, and I firmly believe that graphene can bring the same scale of change in our technological advancements without any adverse effect to the environment and can be the key to a future sustainable way of living. Thank you.